Now for our What in the World segment.
This is fake news.
Fake news.
They have been fake news for a long time.
Come up with a sturdy example of fake news.
The fake news media.
Lambasting real news outlets as fake news.
Fake news peddlers.
You are fake news.
Well, here's the real bad news. You ain't seen nothing yet. A big data analysis of online media released this summer by three communications professors shows that the production of fake news articles has been rapidly growing. Now, to be clear, fake news is not news you don't like. It is content that is intentionally created to mislead the public and is untrue. And the researchers come to a chilling conclusion. When news organizations take the time to fact-check fake stories, they just draw more attention to them. The authors argue that rebutting fake news doesn't work, and newsrooms could better use their resources covering other more important real news stories. But it gets worse. If we can't always believe what we read online, at least we can still believe what we see, right? Wrong. In July, three computer researchers working at the University of Washington used artificial intelligence to generate a fake video of former President Barack Obama. The researchers processed 17 hours of high-definition footage of Obama's actual presidential addresses and created this remarkably photorealistic video. The words are Obama's, but can you tell which of these four videos is fake?
The results are clear. America's businesses have created 14.5 million new jobs over 75 straight months.
Actually, all of them are fake. Back in 2016, another group of researchers created a powerful algorithm which allows actors to create real-time facial reenactments of any public figure. Their stated goal was to create fake videos in a photorealistic fashion such that it is virtually impossible to notice the manipulations. The results are striking. Here's George W. Bush, Vladimir Putin, and Donald Trump. In these examples, actors make facial gestures which are animated in real time with results that are almost seamless. What this all means is that we are rapidly approaching the point where a public figure could be made to say anything.
Most of us don't get our health care through the marketplace.
The ability to create fully convincing fake videos brings up some important questions for consumers of news. On the plus side, I suppose it could lead to a healthy suspicion about all the media we see, which until now we've taken for granted. But let's be clear, it will soon become so easy to make a fake video that there may always be some doubt on all videos, even authentic ones. As Business Insider notes, even if a video isn't fake, a politician caught in a lie or, say, on an Access Hollywood bus making obscene statements could make the argument he's a victim of a fake video.
Grab him by the I could do anything.
There are some technical solutions being floated, including adding digital watermarks on videos to track the true origin of the media. But ultimately, I hope that this makes the public more aware that the credibility of the source matters, that media organizations like CNN and the New York Times and the Washington Post that have standards and checks perform a crucial public role as gatekeepers, sorting through facts and fakes. In the meantime, you'll need to be ever more wary of that article your crazy uncle sent you or that video your college roommate posted on Facebook.